Yeah, last videos we have done the equation of states, right, and the expansion and compression for perfect gas. In continuing with this, in this video we will be studying the basic equation of compressible flow. In that we will be studying in detail with the continuity equation, Bernoulli's equation, momentum equation and equation of states is already been studied already. So we will be studying on continuity equation, Bernoulli's equation, momentum equation here. Now coming to the continuity equation, right? Continuity equation. What is continuity equation? This is based on the law of conservation of mass, right? In which matter cannot be created nor be destroyed, but only it can be transferred from one place to another place, right? That means mass rho a v is equals to constant here. Rho a v is constant value, right? Now what is rho? Rho is the density of the fluid, right? And a is the area of the cross section and v is the velocity at that cross section, right? Now coming to this, we will be differentiating this one. Differentiating the above equation, we will be getting T of rho a v is equals to 0, because differentiation of constant is 0 here. So I can write, first I need to partially differentiate these things, right? That means first initially I will be taking rho a as constant into dv plus rho v into, sorry, rho a into dv, rho a into dv, rho v into dA plus V AV into D rho is equals to 0, right? That means I need to do differentiation for each term here, right? Now what I'll do, I'll divide throughout equation by rho A V. I'll be dividing throughout equation by rho A V. So when I divide that one, I'll be getting dv by v plus dA by a plus t rho by rho is equals to 0, right? This equation is known as continuity equation in differential form. This equation is known as continuity equation in differential form. Differential form. I further will be doing the Bernoulli's equation in the same manner here, right? Now second one I will be doing with respect to the Bernoulli's equation. Bernoulli's equation, right? Oh, Bernoulli's equation. What we have, the Bernoulli's equation? Bernoulli's equation is obtained by the Euler's equation of motion, right? Now Euler's equation of motion, what we have, that is dp by rho plus v into dv plus g into dz is equals to 0. This is nothing but the Euler's equation of motion, right? Now integrating this equation, we will get the Bernoulli's equation, right? Right. Now what I will do, I will integrate this equation. Integrating above equation, we get integration of dp by rho plus integration of v into dv plus integration of g into dz equals 0 here, right? This is equals to constant, right? Integration of 0 is constant here. So integration of this one I'll write as dp by rho plus integration of v into dv is v square by 2 plus integration of g into dz is gz is equals to constant. See, in this case, integration of this term, right, that is integration of dp by rho is not equals to p by rho. Why? Because in compressible flow, density is not constant. But in compressible flow, the density is varying here. So I cannot take a density outside the integration sign. Right? With the change in density, the pressure also changes in the compressible flow. Hence, we cannot directly take integration of dp by rho as p by rho here. Right? But for this, we need to study in two different states here. That is to find out integration of dp by rho for Bernoulli's equation will be obtained by different for two processes. That is one for isothermal and another for the adiabatic process. Right. We need to do two different derivation again for dp by rho here, that is integration of dp by rho. Now, in detail, we'll be studying with respect to the Bernoulli's equation for isothermal process. Question 4. Isothermal process here. Right. Now, for an isothermal process, relation between density pressure is given by p by rho is equals to constant here. Right. Let us say this as C1. Right. Now, I can write this one as p by rho is equals to C1. That means rho is equals to p divided by C1 here. Right. Hence, I can write integration of dp by rho, that means this term here, dp by rho, wherever I have rho, I can substitute as p by c1 here. That is integration of dp divided by p by c1 here. Right? Now, this can be written as integration of c1 into dp divided by p here. Right? So, this term integration of c1, I will take out outside the integration dp by p. It is nothing but c1 log p base e here. Right? This is nothing but the this one dp by rho here. C1 into log p base e. What is c1 here? C1 is nothing but p by rho. So, I can write p by rho into log p base e, right? Now, that means integration of dp by rho is equals to p by rho log p base e here, right? Now, when as after this, what I will do, I will substitute this equation in the Bernoulli's equation, what we have obtained, that is p by rho log p base e plus v square by 2 plus g z is equals to constant here. Right? Now, I will divide throughout equation by g. So, I will get p divided by rho g log p base e plus v square divided by 2 g plus z is equals to constant. Right. This is the Bernoulli's equation for an isothermal process. Right. This is the Bernoulli's equation for isothermal process, or else I can write as P1 by rho 1 G1 log P1 base E plus V1 square by 2 G plus Z1 is equals to P2 by rho 2 g log p log p 2 base e plus v 2 square by 2 g plus z 2. Right? This is what the Bernoulli's equation for an isothermal process. Now,
will be studying in detail with the Bernoulli's equation for adiabatic process. Bernoulli's equation for adiabatic process. Now, adiabatic process is given by P by rho raised to gamma is equals to constant. Let us say that as C2. At P by rho raised to gamma equals constant. That is PV raised to gamma equals constant. V is nothing but the specific volume, that is a reciprocal of density. So, I can write P by rho is equals to constant. P by rho raised to gamma equals constant here. Right. Now, what is rho raised to gamma? Rho raised to gamma is nothing but P divided by C2. Right? Or else I can write rho is equals to P divided by C2 raised to 1 divided by gamma here. Rho is this term. Right. Now, we need to find out for integration of dP by rho here. Substitute rho as this value, that is integration of dP whole divided by P by C2 whole raised to 1 divided by gamma here. That is nothing but C2 raised to 1 divided by gamma divided by P raised to 1 divided by gamma. That is integration of integration of C2 raised to 1 divided by gamma whole divided by P raised to 1 divided by gamma into dP here. Right? Now, I need to find out the integration. That means here integration C2 raised to 1 divided by gamma, I will take it outside the integration sign. Now, remaining will be P raised to minus 1 divided by gamma into dP here. Right? Now, when I integrate this one, that is P raised to minus 1 by gamma, I will be getting C2 raised to 1 divided by gamma is constant. That is P raised to minus 1 divided by gamma plus 1 divided by minus 1 divided by gamma plus 1 here. Right? Now, this term, that is C2 raised to 1 divided by gamma into this P raised to minus 1 plus gamma divided by gamma whole divided by minus 1 plus gamma divided by gamma here. Right? This term becomes C2 raised to 1 divided by gamma, gamma minus 1 divided by gamma divided by gamma minus 1 divided by gamma here. Right. Now, this I can write as gamma divided by gamma minus 1 into C raised to 1 divided by gamma, right, into this is P raised to gamma minus 1 divided by gamma here, right. Now, we got this term here. Right. Now, what is C raised to 1 divided by gamma here? Right. What is C raised to 1 divided by gamma is nothing but, here I can write this one as C2 raised to 1 divided by gamma is equals to P raised to 1 divided by gamma divided by rho here. Wherever I have C, I can substitute it as this term here. Right. So, I will substitute gamma divided by gamma minus 1, right, into C is nothing but P raised to 1 divided by gamma whole divided by rho into P raised to gamma minus 1 divided by gamma here. Now, as the denominators are same, I can add up the numerators. Gamma divided by gamma minus 1, P raised to gamma minus 1 divided by gamma plus 1 by gamma whole divided by rho here. right? This term becomes, as the denominators are same, numerators can be added. This becomes gamma divided by gamma minus 1 into p by rho here. This is nothing but integration of dp by rho. This is for an isothermal or adiabatic process here. Now, the Bernoulli's equation we have. Bernoulli's equation is this one, that is integration of dp by rho. In place of dp by rho, I need to write as gamma divided by gamma minus 1 into p by rho plus remaining will be v square by 2 in plus gz. V square by 2 plus gz is equals to constant. Right? Now, I'll divide throughout equation by g. I'll be getting gamma divided by gamma minus 1 p divided by rho g plus v square divided by 2g plus z is equals to, this is for an adiabatic process, Bernoulli's equation for adiabatic process, right? So I can write this one as gamma divided by gamma minus 1 p1 by 1g plus v1 square by 2g plus z1 is equals to gamma divided by gamma minus 1 p2 by rho 2g plus v2 square by 2g plus z2. This is what the Bernoulli's equation in between two sections here. Right? Thank you.